The five-day impeachment trial has begun against suspended President Dilma Rousseff, and her fate now lies in the hands of Brazil's Senate. This is the final step in a months-long impeachment process against the Workers' Party leader that has been widely condemned by critics as a parliamentary coup. Now, during the trial, the Senate has the power to permanently remove Rousseff from power. And this is over accusations that she manipulated the budget in the lead-up to her 2014 re-election to hide a government shortfall. But the allegations are controversial. Critics point out that Rousseff has never been charged with an impeachable offense. The Independent Federal Prosecutor's Office found last month that Rousseff didn't actually violate any fiscal laws. So what's really behind the impeachment? Politics and power. Rousseff supporters say the impeachment process is just a thinly veiled power grab by the country's conservative elite to revive neoliberal politics. Follow the money, and this looks pretty likely. Although Rousseff's rivals have long attempted to paint her ouster as a campaign against corruption, roughly well over half of the nearly 600 members of the Congress that have driven the impeachment process face major criminal charges, including corruption, bribery, and even kidnapping and murder. Since interim President Michel Temer took the reins of the country in May, three of his ministers have been forced to step down over accusations of bribery and fraud. Temer and his foreign minister José Serra have both been accused of accepting millions of dollars in corporate kickbacks as part of the Petrobras state oil scandal. But if the impeachment is approved, Temer will become president until 2018. And what you can expect from a permanent Temer government is exactly what we've seen over the last 3 months. A rollback of social programs, an attack on social movements, and a further push toward austerity and privatization. That is what is at stake and why the country's most conservative Congress in decades is so keen on removing Dilma Rousseff from power.